And I would not recommend taking your honeymoon to a place like Six Flags Over Texas. The kids in the next room over woke up at 5 o'clock in the morning, hollering and yelling and wanting to go to ride all the rides. Okay, that's enough about all that. It has been a very steep learning curve for me about the issues of sexual health. And one of the things that we can talk about later on our panel discussion tonight are some of the other issues that are very, very important. I brought some additional PowerPoints. But what we want to talk about today is, if we could have the first slide, is something that's really kind of new. Do you ever wonder why you suddenly feel a certain feeling or feel like you are really driven to do something, even though the brain part of you, I can do that from up here, the brain part of you says, where did this come from? You know, we are a product of our brains, right? And as a result of that, sometimes there are things that are going on that we sometimes wonder why we're doing what we're doing, why we're thinking what we're thinking, and why it's so important for you to understand these things. Okay, I will try to do this without walking in front of the screen every time. Can you all hear me? Mm-hmm. Okay.
A little more volume?
All right, we'll see what we can do here. Okay, so here, these are our objectives. We're going to talk about the effects of dopamine, oxytocin, vasopressin on sexual behaviors. We're also going to talk about how life experiences, what happens to you, what has already happened to you, what happened to you as a child in your family of origin can affect the way we look at things and the way we think about things. Now, this is not an insult. You all are very mature. You're very capable of making good judgments. But I will show you evidence that shows very clearly that the most important part of your brain, that part that helps you make decisions, is not fully mature until you're 25. And I will come back to that in just a few minutes. Okay? And then finally, the issue for all of us as society, and you will be an adult soon and be a parent hopefully soon and be a leader soon, that we have to offer guidance to our young people. That's part of what a family does, and once you leave the family unit, that's what professors should be doing and what your church should be doing. Well, these are the lobes of the brain. This is the front over here and the back, and most of you are very well aware of the parts of the brain, the frontal lobe, the parietal lobe, occipital lobe, temporal lobe, and they all have specific functions. The most important part that we're going to talk about this morning is the prefrontal lobe, which is the front of the frontal lobe, okay? And we make jokes about people, you know, well, he needs to have a prefrontal lobotomy, because that's the part of the brain where judgment comes, where actions are prompted. Now, that was a cartoon. This is an actual sagittal section through the brain. It's the same thing. You see the main parts of the brain, and we're going to be talking about that. And the brain is a remarkable organ. And when you think about it, it only weighs 3 pounds, but it has billions of neurons, support cells, connections, and has more connections than all the internet connections in the world. That's inside your head right now. It's wonderful that God has given us that. But I've already mentioned this. It's the prefrontal cortex is the last part of the brain to fully mature, and I'll show you how we know that. The prefrontal cortex is so important because it's the place where we learn, when it's fully mature, judgment, delayed gratification, okay? Seeing into the future, realizing the consequences of what you do today are going to affect you for a lifetime. That's where our moral intelligence is located, abstract thinking, seeing what is not obvious, etc. This is a statement we've already made that until the mid-20s, young people do not have the brain capacity to make totally mature decisions. And I have to be very careful about that. My wife and I married when we were 22. And I tell her I really didn't know what I was doing. But the real benefit for that is that we grew up together, if you will. We matured together. And on September 2nd of this year, we will have been married 42 years. So, very grateful for that. Now, one of the points about that is that if you ask people from liberal organizations, and I'm not here to attack anyone, but if you ask someone from Planned Parenthood, CECAS, these organizations, when young people should start having sex, they will always say, when they're ready. Well, you say, well, what does that mean? Well, it's just when they're ready. Well, most young people are ready at about 15 or 16, which is what they promote. And until more recently have promoted such things as out of...